Hi students, now coming to the next topic in the transport layer, that is the quality of service. So far we have discussed different protocols, TCP, UDP and the congestion control, how you can control the congestion by using the TCP protocol. Now let's see the quality of service, QOS. The quality of service is an overall performance measure of a computer network. So there are some flow characteristics of quality of services there, that is the reliability, delay, jitter and the bandwidth. Now let's see what is this reliability first. So reliability, let me take the paper, I will explain that. Actually the reliability is a, first one is reliability. The first flow characteristics of quality of service is the reliability. So if a packet get lost, let's think that if the packet get lost or acknowledgement is not received, the sender is sending the message and the receiver is receiving the message. Suppose the packet is lost or it doesn't receive any acknowledgement. Then what you'll do? You again retransmit. Okay? Again, the retransmission of data will be needed. So what happens here? The reliability is decreasing. So whenever the retransmission is taking place, this decreases the reliability of a system. Okay. So if a packet gets lost or acknowledgement is not received, the retransmission of data will be needed. This decreases the reliability. Let me take one example like email. The examples of the reliability is email and file transfer. So here the email, whatever the email communication, the file transfer you are taking, in those concepts, you need a reliable transmission as compared to that of an audio conferencing. So rather than when compared to the audio conferencing, here in the email and the file transfer, you need a reliable connection. Whenever you are sending the data, you have to receive the acknowledgement within some time. So, okay. So that is the first quality of service, that is a reliability. Next is delay. We know what is a delay. Delay is doing something slowly. Okay. It's getting the information slowly. Because of delay, something is happening in between the source and destination. That is a delay. A delay of message from source to destination is a very important characteristic. Let's take the example. Here, a time delay. The time delay cannot be tolerated in audio conferencing. Let us take audio conferencing as an example. So here in the audio conferencing, the time delay cannot be tolerated. Why it is cannot be tolerated? Because while you are communicating, you need some delay should be there. It needs a minimum time delay. Okay. So while time delay in email has less important. Okay, while I'm talking to you, okay, if I'm communicating with you, after completing my word, you can able to talk with me. Otherwise, if you didn't receive my message clearly and you are going to respond to my question, if my question is not completed and you are responding to my question, means it's somewhat disturbance is there. It is not tolerable. Okay, the time delay cannot tolerate in audio conferencing. It needs minimum time delay. Whereas in email conferencing, email if you take, it has a less important on time delay. So that is one of the quality of service flow characteristics. And the next is a jitter. Jitter. What is this jitter? It is a variation in packet delay. A jitter is nothing but a variation in packet delay. If difference between delays is larger, then it is a high jitter. If the difference between delays is smaller, then it is a low jitter. High delays is there, large jitter. And a small delays is there, less jitter. Let me explain with one example. Suppose three packets are sent at a time. Three packets are sent at a time. Okay. So first, let's take 0, 1, 2. These packets are received at 10, 11, 12. Okay. So 0, 1, 2 at the time 0, 1, 2. 3 packets are at time 0, 1, 2. And the receiver side it reaches the packets 10, 11, 12. So did you observe here? Here delay is same for all packets. It's a sequence is there. The delay for the packets is same for all packets. So it is acceptable for telephonic conversation. If you take the telephonic conversation, here this type of sending the data means delay is same, then the telephone conversation is acceptable. Suppose if the three packets, that is a 0, 1, 2 will be sent, received at the 31, 34 and 39. It's different times. So here the delays between the packets are different. Okay. So here time delay is not acceptable for telephonic conversation. So that is a, another flow characteristics of the quality of service, that is a jitter. And the next one is the bandwidth. The fourth one is the bandwidth. So the bandwidth here, the different applications needs different bandwidth. Obviously, whenever you have if your applications are different, then the bandwidth is also different. Let's take the example for the video conferencing. If you talk about the bandwidth, in the video conferencing needs more bandwidth when compared to that of sending email. Okay, so obviously if you want to send the data on the email, you can simply send here, there is a less bandwidth is required. But if you are talking on the online, if your video conferencing is there, the Skype is going on, you need more bandwidth when compared to email. Okay, when I'm comparing with the email, at that place the video conferencing needs more bandwidth. So these are the four flow characteristics of the quality of the service: reliability, delay, jitter and the bandwidth. Thank you.